Hi, I'm Fun from 618 Little Chicken. Today I'd like to talk about the two main types of NFTs. Everyone talks about the NFT as it is described on Wikipedia, which is non-fungible token. Non-fungible meaning that each item is irreplaceable by another identical item. Is that really so in all of the NFTs? Here we can look at Adidas original NFT and Murakami flower seed. There's only one token, but there are thousands of owners. 21.6k for Adidas original and 5.9k for Murakami flower seeds. So how could this be? Here we need to talk about ERC 721 and ERC 1155 as two very different forms of smart contracts. Okay, I know, there are just so many alien terms, right? Don't worry. We'll get through this together as wannabe nerds. Okay, well, that's me. You can think about it this way. ERC stands for Ethereum Request for Commands, which is the coding level standards and contracts. Today, we are only going to discuss the two types of commonly used NFT contracts types, 721 and 1155. Put it into the simplest terms, one is that within a project, every single NFT is different. That is ERC 721. And in another, there will only be one single item in the project. We can have multiple owners, and each of the owned item has its unique value. The ERC 721 is unique and can have different value than another token from the same smart contract. So each NFT is unique even under the same collection. For this type of NFTs, although the floor price indicates the least listed price of a project, it is more of a reference for another holder because rarities of each NFT trade's combination or some specific traits means different things to different people. For example, for BAYC, the golden hair ones are more popular and therefore it is usually sold for more. Another example is in Asuki. Some of the NFT dresses like some artists in some of their popular album covers. This might have an impact on how much they are priced too. On the contrary, ERC 1155 uses a single smart contract to represent multiple tokens at once. In ERC 1155 accounts, it has a distinct balance for each token ID, and non-fungible tokens are implemented by simply minting a single one of them. In other words, ERC 1155 is both fungible and non-fungible. This approach leads to a massive gas saving for projects that require multiple tokens. Instead of deploying a new contract for each token type, a single ERC 1155 token contract can hold the entire system state, reducing deployment costs and complexity. To me, knowing this means a lot. Although the floor price of a project typically means how much value an NFT project is guaranteed, ERC 1155's nature makes the floor price more realistic to the project's up-to-date value, because the person getting the NFT at the floor price has no difference to the higher listings. So you can imagine that ERC 1155 NFTs are a bit like cryptocurrencies. I personally prefer ERC 721. They are just so much more fun and so many factors can affect their values. Comment below and let me know which one you'd prefer. See you next time. Bye bye.